Hotel Dusk Room 215 for the DS is Ching, the developer Ching's second attempt at an adventure game for the Nintendo DS. It really isn't a game, more like a novel you interact with, your stylus. Except for the point-and-click puzzles scattered throughout the entire game, much of the interactivity in the game has to do with text dialogues and choosing the right things to say to another character. The puzzles are pretty neat to solve, but the real draw of the game is the text. And seriously, that's the real draw. And it might sound like that's a bad thing, but it's actually like Hotel Dusk, if you ask me. If you ask me to name like my favorite DS game, Hotel Dusk would be like up there with it. Despite the fact that it's really just more of an interactive novel, it's just such an awesome, awesome game. It reveals the true history of a place named Hotel Dusk, and all the odd characters that have come to this place. Of course, all for their own personal reasons. The most important reason, is the reason the main character has decided to come to Hotel Dusk. He initially comes to this run-of-the-mill hotel to do an errand for his peculiar job as a salesman. But as he spends more and more time in the place, he comes to realize that what he's been searching for all this time may finally be discovered in Hotel Dusk. He has been searching for a man named Brad for 3 long years, and the answers seem to exist in this place. And strangely, everyone else that has come to this hotel seem to be the missing pieces to the puzzle. Coincidence or not, everyone, no matter how different or how odd they may be, are connected to the main character's search for truth. Why did Brad betray him 3 years ago? Such a deep and intriguing question stays hidden inside the novelist, who's only been able to write one good book. A lost girl who is apparently mute, a rich and arrogant boy, and even an annoying brat of a girl who's searching for her mother. The game's web of stories is a puzzle you as a gamer must assemble, and this 12 to 15 hour text journey will end in a series of revelations that is bound to shock and entertain anyone who dares solve it. The story moves very slowly as it follows dialogues and events by the minute, but for the patient reader, it is a story that is engaging. Some of you may think that the game should shoot more for interactivity and less story, since that'd make the game too much like a boring book. But I don't know. With the story and characters this deep and this neat, this game is proof that there can be heavily story-driven game that doesn't force the gamer to use violence. There's hardly any violence in this game except maybe the ending parts. Instead, the game requires you to investigate all the rooms of the hotel and solve interesting and sometimes mundane puzzles. Some require the utilization of the touchscreen, such as unwinding cassette tapes by using a pencil, while others require your critical thinking skills, like decoding a set of numbers to figure out a hidden message in a letter. Those are just the coolest puzzles. Investigating and puzzle solving can be a bit frustrating, but for the most part, they're good breaks away from the pages and pages of text you have to read through in this game. Part of the gameplay actually deals with the text dialogue. You're frequently given 2 choices to respond to the other characters, 2 choices. Most of the time, whichever 2 you choose don't make much difference, but there are certain crucial moments when your choice can lead to the other character spilling out his or her secrets to you, while the other choice results in a game over screen. So it's not like Heavy Rain, you know, where you can choose, you know, this game is way before that revolutionary concept of every action having consequences. This game is totally before that. Heavy Rain is really the pioneer of that. I don't think I've seen any other game do that, but anyway, back to this game. So wrong choice in dialogue, game over screen, you do have to repeat over again. So it is archaic in a sense. But most of the time, choosing the right answer is rather obvious and incredibly easy simply because it's common sense. But there are times when both responses seem correct. And on those crucial parts, the game is very unforgiving of any dialogue mistakes. Then it's time to retry and start the dialogue all over again. And hopefully you press your questions and assumptions correctly this time. Oh, and just like Sing's previous and awful, I might add, game, Trace Memory, that's their previous and awful game, there's a quiz section at the end of every chapter. These are really, really easy and only require to remember what different characters said to you. I didn't like these at all and see no point to them, but they act as hints that you have finished the chapter. I guess the quizzes work as devices to better the pacing of the game, but they really do feel tacked on and unnecessary when you consider just how ridiculously easy these quizzes are. So overall, Hotel Dusk succeeds with a really intricate story and investigative puzzles that make you everyday life activities fun and interesting, which is a feat in itself. One thing still bothers me though, and that is trying to figure out whether this is a video game or a novel. I'll just say that it's a novel of a game.